This presentation will provide a brief overview on antibody arrays, how they're made, how they work, and their advantages. The antibody array is a powerful tool that uses antibodies to detect tens to thousands of proteins simultaneously. Detection of specific proteins is possible because each antibody, which is depicted on the right, binds to a unique protein. Antibody arrays enable protein profiling, which is the measurement of protein expression levels that are specific to a sample within a particular set of conditions at a distinct point in time. Because of this, antibody arrays have numerous applications, ranging from drug discovery to food security. Antibody arrays are generated by immobilizing antibodies onto a solid substrate. When a sample is incubated on the array, each antibody will bind to their specific target. The captured protein is then detected directly or indirectly via chemiluminescence or fluorescence. Because the antibodies are spotted in an addressable format, the identities of the captured proteins are easily ascertained. Label-based antibody arrays rely on only one antibody, the capture antibody, per target protein. The captured protein is labeled with a detection molecule for direct detection. Sandwich-based antibody arrays rely on two antibodies per target protein, a capture antibody and a detection antibody. In some cases, a detection molecule specific for the target protein can be used, such as a lectin that binds a specific glycan or a DNA aptamer with an affinity to the protein. Antibodies are immobilized onto a solid support called a substrate. These substrates can include a glass slide, a membrane made from nitrocellulose or PVDF, and microbeads. Proteins captured onto the arrays are detected using chemiluminescence or fluorescence. In general, glass-based antibody arrays use a laser scanner to measure fluorescence, whereas membrane-based antibody arrays are compatible with any instrument capable of measuring chemiluminescence. For example, chemiluminescence can be measured with the same detection instruments that are used for imaging Western blots. Finally, the fluorescence from bead-based arrays is analyzed with a flow cytometer. The data obtained with antibody arrays are simple to interpret. The signal output is proportional to the amount of protein. Here, three proteins were targeted using a glass-based antibody array. Protein A has little to no fluorescent signal. Protein B has low signal, and protein C has high signal. Let's pretend for the moment that the proteins have the following shapes. If we were to look at the expression levels of these three proteins in the original sample, in this case within a cell, we would see that protein A is hardly expressed, protein B is moderately expressed, and protein C is highly expressed. Different types of data can be obtained with antibody arrays. Qualitative data are fluorescent and chemiluminescent signals that are assessed only by eye, which are often not accurate. Semi-quantitative data means that the signals are assigned values, such as pixel intensities. Because of this, relative fold changes of protein expression levels can be determined. A general statement made with semi-quantitative data is, sample B has more protein X than sample A. Signals are also assigned values with quantitative data. However, unlike semi-quantitative data, quantitative data includes a standard curve, which means that the absolute protein concentration in the sample can be determined. A general statement made with quantitative data is, sample B has 200 micrograms per milliliter of protein X, while sample A has 100 micrograms per milliliter of protein X. Antibody arrays have many advantages. They are compatible with numerous sample types, including serum, cell lysate, tissue lysate, conditioned media, urine, and milk. They are a flexible format, so they can be easily customized to target specific proteins of interest. Antibody arrays produce different types of data that are simple to interpret and require no dedicated equipment. They're easy to use, requiring little to no specialized training. Compared to single-plex assays for measuring proteins like ELISA, antibody arrays require less sample volume, less materials, and less labor. Thus, arrays are cost and time effective. Compared to another high-throughput proteomics technology, mass spectrometry, antibody arrays do not require that the sample proteins are digested into peptides or that highly abundant proteins are depleted so that lower abundant proteins can be detected. Ion suppression, which is a phenomenon that suppresses the detection of proteins during mass spectrometry analysis, is also not a concern with antibody arrays. For more information about selecting the right antibody array for your study, or comparing mass spectrometry and antibody arrays for protein profiling, please check out the links below. If you have questions about antibody arrays, you can visit our webpage at www.raybiotech.com or email us at info@raybiotech.com.